Greetings, YouTube. It makes sense given that Cavalier is the most sought-after difficulty level now in terms of progression in Marvel Contest of Champions that we spend a large majority of our time talking about what it takes to become Cavalier and all of the hoops you have to jump through to get there. But I don't want that to underscore just how difficult it is to get Uncollected status. And how important of a milestone that is for so many of you watching this who aren't yet Uncollected, but whose goal is to at least be Uncollected before July 4th. Now, I've also heard from several of you that have said, Prof, I am planning on doing what you're doing, which is hoarding units. My goal is to keep at least 15,000 units in my inbox for July 4th, because either I can't afford any of the offers that are coming, or simply put, I'm not happy with where the game is. And even if they're great offers, I'm not going to buy them up. But if I already have units in my inbox, then I can at least take advantage of the unit offers without spending money. So you've got people who are saying that they're essentially going to be living that free-to-play, unit-hoarding, arena-grinding till your soul is long left your body lifestyle. So my goal in this video is to do something that I do about once or twice a year, and that is to talk about which champs are going to be best for you to become Uncollected, using so much of the feedback that I have been given in the past several years. But keep in mind that this feedback is still just what I have learned myself and what I've heard from others. And that does not at all encapsulate the full scope of what the community does every day when they become Uncollected. So there are going to be champions that I don't talk about or that I fail to talk about because I don't even know that they're being used. And that's where the comment section of this video is so important. This kind of video is to help our fellow summoners out who have a limited roster, most likely four stars. When I'm talking about four stars, I'm not talking about rank fives. I'm talking about a lot of rank four stars. And they are at times also not having these champions awaken. So I'm going to do my best to go through all six classes, and I'm going to talk about them in the form of four-star champions because that is what is most realistic. If you have the five-star equivalent of these, great for you. Obviously, it still works, but then again, there are champions like Wolverine and especially Scarlet Witch who don't have a chance to ever become more than four stars thanks to what Kabam Mike said literally broke the game. Okay, so when it comes to the science class, I'm going to start out with an underrated champion, and that is Mr. Hulk, the OG Hulk. Why? I have known people who do the Hulk cheese. They'll get a bunch of special one, level one revives. I don't know why I call them special one. That's not what they're called. Level one revives, 20% health, and they'll bring in their Hulk, and, you know, Hulk gets that awesome ability to gain super strength, and when he has that threshold, when his health drops below 25%, he gains a massive fury for 8 seconds, increases attack by 1,349. So, you know that a level 1, not special 1, revive is 20% health. And so you just hope to maybe land a parry or an intercept and just do enough damage on the collector to where you're taking him down. And then if the regen starts, you just force quit the fight, pump a level 1 health potion back into him, and you're good to go. Some honorable mentions I've heard. Thing, Hulk, the Gladiator version, Human Torch. I even had somebody tell me once that they used MODOK, tried to get lucky on the parries, and just did heavies. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know anybody who's taken She-Hulk in, but I can see her being, you know, a fairly stable option in some cases. Void, I wouldn't do good with because I feel like Void is like fine wine. The longer the time goes on, the better it gets. And my fights with the Collector tend to be pretty short because I simply just didn't have the skills or the patience to last longer, internet phrases. But speaking of that, an awakened Luke Cage, to have that indestructible, I get hit but I'm not dead effect, really, really powerful. And speaking of which, this is just a side note, but the Heimdall synergy for the Collector, similar to what I used in my Abyss completion run, to give you a little bit more time to attack, that's going to help a ton for you potentially as well. So just consider that. And speaking of the Collector from my last experience, I did use Aegon, and while certainly you're not going to have the chance to have nearly as high of a combo count as you would in, say, Labyrinth of Legends or the Abyss as you would in Act 5, when Aegon gets hit and you get those Furies and you have Heimdall and you increase the damage and then you go into the Collector, I've also seen that be very effective. Heck, I've seen people do good work with Crossbones. I don't know about the new Black Widow. Squirrel Girl might be good. Don't know about her yet. Haven't heard yet. Nick Fury, I have been told, especially if you get lucky and the shrugs off with the tenacity-like effect with the bleeds, works in your favor. Nick Fury can be good. Gwenpool is one of the top options. And keep in mind that that awakened ability could literally save you, especially when you combine it with something like I just discussed with Heimdall, because Gwenpool's doesn't die, preventing her from losing more than 65.3% of her current health per hit from special attacks. So Gwenpool could be a solid option. Daredevil Classic, believe it or not, was also a great option. Awakened at a high sig for me as a 4-star back in the day, because you start out the fight and you obviously can dodge those projectiles, but as ability accuracy starts to wane, so does your ability to evade those projectiles, but it does take a little while. Black Widow can also be a fairly effective champion. I'd bring Quake in to up her sig a bit. And then, you know, you've got some classics that people still say, I'll just bring in. Blade is one of them. And I haven't seen anybody use Night Monkey yet, Mr. Stealth Spidey, but I'm sure that is a option going forward for some people. Now, we could spend a lot more time on that class, but this is supposed to be just a brief overview, as brief as this can be when you're covering over 100 champions. Okay, Archangel, if you get lucky at first and you maybe land some heavies and you get some neurotoxins and none of that gets drugged off, it's kind of like an RNG prayer fest. So I don't know how reliable bringing in Archangel is for that fight, but maybe it is. I've seen some luck with Domino. I've seen some luck with Sunspot. Heck, I've even seen some luck with Iceman, though I wouldn't really say that he's a top option. I would imagine, though I haven't seen anyone do this, that the buffed Colossus could be a good option for the Collector, as would Emma Frost, who does not need to be awakened. If you could get Havoc to a special 3 particularly, I can see that being effective, but will you last long enough? I probably wouldn't. I've just got to be honest. From there, you scroll down, and I look at most of these champions and just think, yeah, I wouldn't bring them in. Would not bring them in. But hey, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe Mr. Sinister is an incredible counter to the Collector that I never knew. Or Old Man Logan now is an incredible counter. This is where the comment section is so important. Omega Red, I just don't think that's the Omega Red fight that that champion is built for. Kind of reminds me of Void, where if you're able to have the spores stack up and you land a heavy to keep them in place and they're not shrugged off, that can be effective, but there just isn't the level of RNG in your favor that I would be comfortable promoting at this point. Okay, I've heard from some people that Medusa was a good option for them. I've even heard that the patch 12.0 neutered Thor has been a good option. Personally, if you can last it, I can see Hyperion putting in some work as that power gain does its thing. I can see Superior Iron Man or Iron Man Awakened at least giving you a little bit longer of a fight with that region, but they still are what the company or the game likes to call a wet noodle, I should say community. Now, Corvus is an interesting choice because usually the people who tell me that they don't understand why Corvus is so great, they think he's overrated, they haven't understood or accomplished getting his missions. If you can look at a path to become uncollected and say, okay, there's a tech on the path, there's a mutant, maybe there's an Avenger and an evade champ, and you can build up at least 2, but ideally 3 or 4 missions before you get to the Collector, and you can just do the old Corvus cheese, where you get a bunch of crits in at the beginning of the fight, and then when the regen starts to happen, maybe you quit out. That's a great option. I can see Venom being a solid option, especially once the Collector gets down, below 18% health. And then Cole Obsidian, I've been told, especially if you can get the root on or route on. I always hear it pronounced both ways. Venom the Duck, YouTube. Have you used Venom the Duck before on? I can see. Captain Marvel movie, have you used her on the Collector? I can see both those being good options. I just haven't heard that before. And we are going to jump straight to one of the most reliable options still to this day in June of 2020 at the time of recording this. And this is our man, Spider-Man Stark Enhanced. He may be my top recommended option against the Collector still. If you can build those poise charges, remember with Blade, you start with 3 with that synergy. and you can get him up to 10. You can just do some crits, man. And that awakened ability really is only important and an important thing to remember when his health is above 50%. Remember, taunts, Spider-Man's taunts last 2 seconds longer, and each charge of poise grants him an additional 253.58 critical rating. This is why some people, like my boy Dooley Ray, beat Labyrinth of Legends with Stark Spidey, but also use enough potions to always get him above 50% health before he went into the fight again. But besides that, if you're going to bring in a Vision, I'd recommend OG if you've got him. But he still hits like a wet noodle, although if you pair him with Warlock, that would certainly help. Warlock! Haven't had anybody tell me, either with Warlock or Guillotine 2099, they've used them against the Collector, but I can see them being solid options. Darkhawk, in some cases, I think so too. Sentinel, maybe. Ghost, yes. If you are a good Ghost fighter, and you have things like, say, the Ant-Man, Wasp, Hood synergy, certainly the Wasp synergy, if no one else, that could really help you. So, if you've got the skills, Ghost, I mean, for most fights, right? It's obvious at this point. Star-Lord, I used to bring in, but I couldn't build my combo high enough to really matter before I die. Now, maybe you have more skills with Star-Lord. Of course, he's got to be awakened for that to factor in. But we're going to move on to the last class. I have actually seen incredibly high success rates with Dr. Voodoo against the Collector. So, yes, Dr. Voodoo, ideally awakened, is a solid option. Scarlet Witch, still awakened, can be a solid option against the Collector. Dr. Doom, one of those champions that you just assume is going to be a great option for most fights. I haven't seen any Doom gameplay against the Collector in Chapter 5, or Act 5, I should say. What do you think? Have you used Dr. Doom against the Collector? Have you been effective? Prof, who did you use against the Collector? You know who I used? Juggernaut. What? This was poor man's, poor man's Corvus. I started out unstoppable, and I had a 5-star awakened Juggernaut at this point, because I was lucky, quote-unquote. I would get a bunch of hits in because I knew I could charge the Collector, and as long as I had at least a, gosh, level 1 revive in me, he couldn't do enough damage at the start of the fight even when I was unstoppable and he was hitting me first to kill me. And then I would get, you know, a couple thousand damage in. It wasn't a lot. And then before the regen started, I would quit. I would not recommend this given how many other better champions are out there, including the synergies I talked about with Heimdall and Corvus. But this was my option back in the day, and it worked. So that's how I beat the Collector. And that's also how it's kind of fun to talk about unique options. Now, some members of this class that might also be fun. Morningstar, Black Widow Clairvoyant, Symbiote Supreme, Dormammu. Heck, I'm sure Longshot could do a good amount of damage. I have seen some cases, if you get to the special too, where magic could actually also do good work. But I wasn't skilled enough with magic back in the day to really have that verified. YouTube, I know this is a longer video than normal, but I had to go super fast to even make it this short. So, this is an overview. Who did I miss? Is Mephisto a good choice? What other champions of different classes have you used that summoners might have that weren't touched on in this video that they can become uncollected before July 4th? Remember, the key is to get the progression level so that you can get the best deals, and we've seen in the past year, and certainly this is going to continue in 2020, that progression levels trigger better offers, particularly when it comes to both the unit store and units in general. And so you don't want to get worse offers between now and July 4th. Even if you're free to play, if you're just hoarding units, it still applies. So I hope that this advice has been helpful, and I know this was a lot to take in. I don't know a better way to cover 100-plus champions than this. But at the same time, if it helps at least one person, then the video did its job. That is honestly my motto, no matter what video I make. My Marvel Contest, or in this case, Marvel Casino of Champions YouTube channel. Have a great day.